I wanted to make a sandbox for our little ones, so I designed it roughly in SketchUp and then disassembled that into pieces and printed those out to take to the shop for cutting.
I start by cutting the pieces of cedar to length on the table saw. I don't use a miter saw because to set one of those up properly, you'd pretty much have to dedicate a whole wall to it. I'm going to join the corners of this box with some very coarse sort of box joints. I widened up this slot here so I can get in there with a bandsaw and cut this part out. Now I have to adjust the stop for the complementing pieces that fit in between. And now I can cut the rest of these notches on the table saw. And now rounding the ends because those will protrude a little bit. And this is how the box goes together. I want to screw these together with deck screws from the bottom, but my screws aren't long enough, so I'll have to sink these in a little bit. And now some pilot holes all the way through, and that'll help the screws pull the pieces together. I couldn't get all the way through with the drill press. I'm adding a cutout to one side to make it a bit easier to reach in or climb in. And now some pilot holes to avoid cracking the ends of the pieces of wood. Time to start assembling it. I beveled this edge a bit just to hide these bottom boards a little bit, and because I'm so close to the ends of the boards, I drilled pilot holes so I won't be splitting them. Now, these two things are going to be the legs, but I'm going to screw these in from the top. I spaced the legs far enough apart so I can still get a moving dolly under it, so maybe we can still move it around the patio once it's full of sand. I still want to make a lid for the sandbox, and for that I'm going to use some scrap sheet metal roofing, and I'll mount that on a frame so that the sharp edges won't be exposed. At the corners, I'm just going to join it with some long screws which I'll sink a ways in so I get enough in both pieces. I drilled some holes in here for sinking the heads real deep in here without splitting this piece of cedar. And now I just need to mark where pilot holes in this part need to be. Right here. Did you know you could cut sheet metal roofing with a utility knife? I didn't film bending the rest of this metal because it got real inelegant. And I certainly wouldn't want to encourage you to try what I tried. But it's okay. There's still some exposed edges, but I sanded all of them, so nothing is sharper than the stuff the kids already play with.
Can you help put the pan in the pan? Can you help me to lift it up?
I'll help you.
Okay, thank you.
I'll help you.
Ready? That's it. Put it up. And in the sandbox.
A sandbox. I found
you.
I
found you. Wow.
Wow.
Now I need some more sand, that's right.
The idea of this design is that it's easier to play standing next to it than to get into it, so hopefully we'll get a little bit less sand into the house that way.